First, I'm gonna go over skating attire. So I basically wear the same thing every skate session. First, I love to layer. Sometimes it's cold, and then you heat up after you warm up a little bit. I love this 32 degrees vest. It's packable and foldable. It throws very easily into my skating bag. It's perfect to put my phone in, tissues, etc., skating marker, you got it, it fits. Another layer I absolutely love is my Lululemon jacket. So this is just a standard black jacket, so it's perfect for skating, for testing, for competition. A lot of my students have it too, and they get their cute little name embroidered on it or a logo on the back. For pants, I really like the Under Armour cold gear. I've used this ever since I was a kid training as well. I just feel like, you know, you fall a lot, it doesn't get moist, and it keeps you nice and warm, but it's also breathable at the same time. I also love that it's quite stretchy. I personally just like putting the leggings over a little bit of my boot. If you know, you know. Lastly is a hat. Usually when I'm skating, I don't wear a hat too often. When I'm coaching, I'm definitely team hat because heat escapes out of your head, of course. So I love the Car Hat brand. I have like 5 different colors of this. I wear it at the rink, but also for snowboarding, skiing, and out in cold Colorado. So next, I'm going to take stuff that's literally in my skating bag.
Tum Tum, those are my skates. Don't eat them. Don't eat them. Oh, man. Oh, man.
This is my kitty. Hi. Not included in the skating bag. I have so many things in here. The more pockets you have, the more stuff you put in. So first, these are the Chloe Noel soakers. Penguins are my favorite animal. So I grew up skating for Penguin Figure Skating Club. So this is just nostalgic and sentimental, the penguin. But I love these. For soakers, it's important to keep them on your skates after your session and until your next session, because even though you wipe down your guards, sometimes with condensation, there's still a little bit of water remaining. So a good pair of soakers will take care of the rest. So I personally like kind of like the terry cloth material. There are some other materials like fleece and stuff. I just don't think they work as well, but these work great. So they come in lots of different animals. I match with a lot of my students. And then hard guards, of course. So when you are going out onto the ice or walking around, going to the bathroom, you need to protect your blades. You never know what you step into, what you accidentally kick. Your blades are expensive, so it hurts my soul to see people walk without their guards on. Anyways, these are the Guard Dogs brand. Oh, I just got it on Amazon. I like these a lot. They're adjustable. You just cut them and they fit lots of different lengths. And they also last for a long time. Again, I've had these for several years. There are some skate guards that I've had students wear that just retain water and they tend to rust. I don't think that these do this. And they also stay on. The other kind of pet peeve or annoyance with guards is like they fall off. But these have never fallen off on me. Highly recommend. Oops, sorry, Tum Tum. Let's see what else is in my skating bag. I have the Adeo spinner. I love this for my students. I feel like there are several exercises you can do on this to help them find their air position for jumps, but also for spins to find their best optimum position, balance point. And I also use these for three turns, brackets, etc. So I love this tool. I have the standard one. They have a newer one with a notch and a rubber band that you can use for jumping. That's a little bit more difficult to maneuver, but I do like that one for jump takeoffs as well. I have a butt pad. So they are crash pants and crash shorts. I really like those a lot. But if you just want something quick and easy to throw on your bag, I have this. So this is a tailbone one. If you fall more on your hips, they have one for your left and right hip as well. Again, I use these as a kid. I use these as an adult too if I feel adventurous and like doing crazy jumps, but they slip on and off easily. They're packable and they're super light as a feather. So we all know some skaters have stinky feet. I am guilty. So I love these. I don't know how they work, but they absorb the smell. So I keep my skates in the coach's room and you know, they're stinky. So these really help, you know, coworkers thank me. We got a washable patterns. I draw notes. I draw tic-tac-toe. I draw names, especially for group lessons. So this is a must, and it comes off with every exam. So washable marker, don't use permanent marker. And then we all know as skaters, we always lose skating tights. So I have a bazillion pairs of these. Super inexpensive on Amazon. They lasted great. I haven't really gotten holes in these. And I could just throw them in the wash. And if I lose them, no big deal because I have a million pairs. Let's see what's in this pocket. Well, you can't forget about the Bunga pads. So they are a skating essential for me. So I sometimes get blisters around my ankles, or they get a little tight, or I tie them too tight and get lace bite. So I feel like with the bungle pads, it really helps with the friction. I just can't skate without them. You know, I am a bungle pad and tights kind of person. Some people skate barefoot, whatever you like. What kind of skater are you? Just comment below. I am curious. Magic gloves, they are a must. I like how breathable they are because I tend to get sweaty hands when I skate. Some people skate without gloves, and I do encourage doing run-throughs of your program and tests in that so you get used to it. But for practicing, especially if you're falling and doing hydroblades and slides on the ice, I love having gloves. So these magic gloves, I love. So that wraps up my Amazon favorites for skating. Be sure to like, subscribe, and save. I have all the links below.